Hello, my name's Caden on Ninjago and More, and what you're seeing is the oldest picture I can find of my Ninjago figure baseplate. This comes between an interaction between me and who I believe was Albrick Studios, or Ninja Al, when he was trying to get me to send him gift cards. In this photo, you're seeing a more updated version of my baseplate. This was on a 48x48 baseplate. This picture was taken on New Year's Day 2020. You can see all of my ninja hair and all of my side characters here. I also have this photo, which is of my second 48x48 base plate, which had every single villain figure I had. As you can see, definitely not as many as I have now. Then, in March 2020, I tried super gluing two 48x48 base plates together. This did not work at all, and I quickly abandoned the idea. And from then on, while I did experiment once or twice with how I displayed my figures, the format more or less always stayed the same. Grey baseplate, all the ninjas on one, all the villains on the other. Very basic. But as you can see, in this screenshot from September 2020, I always wanted more. I wanted it to be bigger. I wanted it to be better. And after dwelling, this is a random picture, by the way, it has nothing to do with what I'm actually saying. After dwelling for months, I finally had a good idea. Lego art sets. As soon as I saw the way these sets were built, I knew I had to do something with minifigures. A standard Lego art set is comprised of 9 of these 16x16 base plates. When I saw these, I immediately knew these would be perfect for building a flexible, customizable minifigure display. As eager as I was to make my dream a reality, it never happened. The base plates I knew would be too expensive, and I didn't even know where I could buy them from. I mean, I could have used Bricklink, but I would have needed to use dozens and dozens of different sellers to buy these base plates. It would have costed hundreds just with shipping alone. And so, I let the idea rest. And for 2 years, 2 years, I left it. It was always, always in the back of my mind. I knew I wanted to do something, but there was nothing I could do. It was too expensive. I didn't know where I could buy the pieces from, so I left it. That was until my birthday, August 2022. I realized you could buy these art base plates on the Lego Pick-A-Brick website. They were expensive, almost £3 each. And for the amount I was going to need, plus Technic pins and other bricks to hold them all together, it was going to be £140. I spent days contemplating whether I should do it or not. But I gave in. I wanted so badly to see my idea come to life. So I paid the £140 and then I waited. And then, exactly 1 month after I had ordered them, they arrived. Now the footage you're about to see is from a scrapped video I was going to make the day these base plates arrived.
Hello, my name's Caden on Ninjago and More, and I'm so excited because today I have 36 of these pieces.
And after about 3 hours of assembly, this is the finished product. I am so happy with this. These Lego figures are my life's work. And as pathetic as that sounds, I am so, so proud of them. This base plate, I believe, is a unique design for displaying minifigures, and I could not be happier. So now, just for a minute, I'm going to stop voicing over and I'm going to do you a full kind of tour of this base plate. So I'll see you in just a second. So here I have all of my ninja suits. Pretty much every single ninja suit ever made is on this base plate. That is including unique variations, the dragon forms, of course, and even some customs. We have the tournament ninja in disguise, we have the ninja in disguise in season 16. This is insane. Over here we have the villains. There are so many villains, possibly even more than there are ninja. I am so happy with this. Look at that. There are my side characters at the back there, my woos here. This is every single Woo figure ever made. We have Baby Woo there, Dragon Master Woo, Season 16 Woo,
OG Wu. This is incredible. It is so big, it doesn't even fit on my desk, so I've had to record this on my bed. That is actually why I've put off filming this video for so long, because I had nowhere to film it. I thought on my bed looked a little bit unprofessional, but I'm so excited to share this with people. I honestly don't care where it's recorded at this point.
Now, I love this base plate and I would love to show it off more, but only if people are interested in seeing it. So if you want to see more of this base plate, you want to see how I put it together, you want to see each individual minifigure, anything like that, then drop me a comment on this video, or if comments are turned off, send me a message on Instagram at ninjagoandmore, no spaces, and yeah, let me know you want to see more of this. I will make more videos of these. I will do updates when I add figures to this, if that's what people want to see. I love this. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye.